late Saturday or Sunday against the Cubs. He too has had a hamstring issue.
He really tried to lobby his way into the lineup tonight. He wasn't initially scheduled to be in the lineup, but as batting practice went on, he's trying to make a case for himself, and I think the Giants all agreed to give him one more day so he has a chance to play tomorrow. But here he is with a chance to send home everybody happy.
And then a wicked cut and a foul out of play.
Or he can send home everybody happy. Or everybody home happy.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Oh, we good. Belt with a good lead now. And he popped it up. Kemp's got to go a long way, so it's Amarista. And it's going to fall. And here comes Belt. And this game is over. I do not believe it. Unbelievable.
That is unbelievable.
And Johnny Cueto is going to get a win. Kemp was playing very deep. So then it was up to Amarista, who couldn't get it.
All right, time now for our play of the game. It's brought to you by Honda. Well, Johnny Cueto, two hits allowed, one hit pass with six strikeouts, only one runner in scoring position the whole night. And in his 10th start, the Giants have now won nine. Let's take a look at the hit that ended it. And you can see how deep the Kemp was playing. It was a long run for him. He looked for help. Amarista looked for help. They kicked it away. And with two outs, Brandon Belt had a great jump. He scores all the way from first, and everybody goes home happy.
Well, the kick at the very end is what did it. The player's thinking, I may have one here. Don't hurt yourself.
Well, if you're going to have a good year, you have to have breaks like that. But he sure pitched like a champion tonight.
Belt is on the move once it's hit, and now you really got to go. So kick it in, Brandon. All right, final score. Giants 1. Padres nothing. Unbelievable. Thanks for joining us. Stay tuned. Giants Post Cave Live with interviews and the Wrap starts right now.